Hello, beautiful people. I wanted to do a short video about a topic that has been weighing heavily on my mind. I gotten so many emails because I've said that Zelensky, the guy, the president of Ukraine, it's been proven that he's been lying about them. How do you say them? The missiles that fell in Poland. Okay. And I've received so many emails from people saying how disappointed they are in me that I said that he's lied about it. But this is not something that I am saying. This is everybody. I mean, this is the press in the left, the press in the right, the United Nations, everybody. This is something that this is beyond proof. Many people are saying that, oh, it's because they're trying to blame him because they don't want to start World War III if they blame Russia. That's a fair point. However, that's not an accurate one. And this is the thing when people become blinded to certain people or certain ideas. And unfortunately, sometimes it gets corrupted. The same topic. This is why we have people like who are absolutely blind to Meghan Markle. I'm not gonna lie to you. I had a bias, not a bias, but when I saw her with Harry the first time, everybody was talking that she was an A-lister Hollywood star. You know, when you say an A-lister Hollywood star, you imagine somebody like Meryl Streep, Julia Roberts, Glenn Close, Jennifer Lawrence. So, I literally had to Google Meghan Markle. And I didn't even know, I had to find out that there's some sort of cable in the series. And from the get-go, the fact that the press was trying to turn her into something that she wasn't was a big red flag for me. Because why? There was no need to build her up as though what she was wasn't enough. So I don't know if it was Meghan Markle who decided that, you know what, you need to build me up because I gotta take advantage of this. So you have to build me up so I can look better, so I can be on par with the royal family. There was no need for her to ever do that. Look at Princess Diana. Look at the Duchess. Well, the Duchess of West, the Countess of Wessex, Sophie. She was an extremely well-respected professional in her field, but she was nowhere near on par with the royal family. The Duchess, the Princess of Wales, the current Princess of Wales, but Meghan Markle felt the need to build herself up so the royal family would be like, oh my God, this A-lister millionaire Hollywood actress is denigrating herself by is doing the monarchy a favor by marrying into the monarchy. She wanted to be like Grace Kelly. That Grace Kelly was an actual A-lister. She was an Oscar winner actress. She was at the top level in her craft. So it is my view that this is what Meghan Markle wanted to build herself to be. So she would be the next Grace Kelly instead of the next Wallis Simpson. Unfortunately, in this, it is a blessing and it is a curse nowadays. The internet is everywhere. You can build your images, but then at the same time, it's easy to find that what you're saying, whether it's bullshit or not. I got so many emails saying, oh, look at you, you're hiding behind a, where am I hiding? Guys, you see me on my videos. I gave you my name, my last name. I mean, you guys know about my life. So these people say, oh, it's easy for you to behind a camera. No, it wasn't. It isn't easy. You get a lot of hate mail. So what? I deal with it. But to me, this is why there were so many red flags. And I was wondering, who is the person building this woman up? Because no matter how hard I looked, I could not find Meghan Markle as an A-lister, not even a B-lister, not even a C-lister in the Hollywood radar. I found an actress in a cable B-rated or C-rated show filmed in Canada. That's what I found. She wasn't chased by the paparazzi like the Duchess of, like the Princess, both Princesses of Wales, or any other royal bride. Nobody. And the reason it is my firm belief that she wanted Harry to come out and say she's my girlfriend is because in the press, nobody ever thought in a million years that Harry would be interested in a person like me, like Meghan Markle. And it's nothing to do with skin color. It's just that she is unremarkable in every way. And she is so pretentious and such a, and, you know, it's just, she's just like Jamila, the girl that she had there. If you go to her Wikipedia page, it's basically a fantasy land, just like that TMZ documentary that they did no BS about Meghan Markle and Harry. I mean, literally, guys, I don't know who told more lies in that documentary or Oprah and the Oprah thing, you know. And make no mistake, that is paid for by Meghan Markle. It is my humble opinion. Clearly, these are my thoughts and opinions. But I mean, when I give my opinions, many of you are offended, and I appreciate that you write and you say that you're going to unsubscribe from my channel because I said something terrible about Selenesky, or I said something terrible about Meghan Markle, or that I'm an extremely racist person. Race has nothing to do with it. I was actually quite concerned that Meghan could be Latino or Hispanic, you know, because she looked like it. And this is for me why the press, in many ways, went along with Meghan Markle's narrative, because everybody was terrified of calling her out. Because from the very beginning, Meghan Markle wanted Harry to let the world know that she was his girlfriend, so she would get PR, and maybe she would be chased by paps. But nobody ever chased her, not even in Canada or when she went to visit him in London, you know. Nobody followed her. Nobody cared, you know. She could go out and party and go to restaurants or anything. They would follow them if it was Prince Harry. But Meghan alone? No. I mean, this woman goes out and about in L.A. Nobody's chasing her because that's not the way the world works now. And also because she's not that worthy, you know. Do you think that... Why do you think news paparazzi are waiting for Kim Kardashian at a certain restaurant? Because they're tipped in advance that they're going to be there. But to Meghan Markle's detriment, nobody shows up, maybe one. You know. So for me, that's why she pushed Harry into saying that she was his girlfriend, because she wanted the pap, she wanted the press, whether she stayed with him or not. But she would still be famous. Please leave me your comments. And as usually, thank you for liking, sharing, and subscribing. You guys are amazing. Thank you, thank you, thank you.